Good afternoon, my jury members, respected chairman, and the other participants present in the meeting. I am Dr. Ritika Verma, postgraduate student in the Department of Periodontology at Manav Rachna Dental College. The title of my e-poster category is DNA Extraction from Dental Remnants, and it is taken from a comparative study that is done by Kafiro C. et al. In 2019. Next slide, ma'am. DNA, that is deoxyribonucleic acid, it is a molecule that is composed of two polynucleotide chains that coil around each other to form a double helix, carrying genetic instructions for the development, functioning, growth, and reproduction of all known organisms and many viruses. Basically, DNA and RNA are nucleic acids. Molecular biology techniques can be applied in forensic medicine to deny or confirm the source of ancient bone remains from an archaeological site and verify the unknown identity of an individual. Efficient DNA extraction procedures is a critical step involved in the process of successful DNA analysis of such samples. Various protocols have been devised for the genomic DNA extraction from human tissues and forensic stains, such as the dental tissues, that is the skeletal part that better preserves the DNA over the time. Now, the sources of DNA during the process of extraction include the teeth, the bone, the hair follicle, the blood cells, the saliva, and the semen. In the early onset of, In the early onset of the postmortem phase, the blood and the bodily fluids decompose, which led to DNA degradation, beginning with the release of endogenous intracellular enzymes. Teeth, on the other hand, are a skeletal structure that better preserve DNA over time due to their anatomy with a naturally hard mineral composition and low porosity. Teeth are more resistant to contamination compared to the bone. In addition, it is noted that the exogenous DNA is often less degraded when compared to the endogenous DNA and can interfere with genetic analysis, resulting in erroneous DNA profiles. For these reasons, achieving high quality of DNA in extraction is still challenging. The figure on the right side, it lists the basic steps that are involved in all DNA procedures. Firstly, any source can be chosen for the process of DNA extraction, which can include a cell culture, a tissue extract, or basic blood samples. The cells are then lysed by physical or chemical methods. The physical methods are the mechanical methods, which include the mechanical disruption, and the chemical methods includes the use of phenols. And the cell debris is usually removed with the help of detergents and centrifugation. The proteins are denatured and digested using a protease and precipitated with organic solvents such as phenols. The protein precipitate is removed following separation by centrifugation, and the purified DNA is obtained. Now, the forensic scientists, they can use DNA profiles to identify criminals or determine the parentage. A DNA profile is like a genetic fingerprint. Every person has a unique DNA profile, making it very useful for identifying people involved in a crime. Ma'am, next slide. So basically, there are two techniques reviewed for the DNA extraction, mainly the classical technique and the new technique. The classical technique refers to the process that is followed for DNA extraction since a long time. The material required for the classical technique include the Teflon pestle, the ceramic motor, EDTA solution, and DNA shaker. And for the new technique, the armamentarium includes the stereo microscope, the carborundum disc, handpiece, bi-bevel chisel, and med mallet. The classical method of DNA extraction from the teeth, it includes pulverization or grinding and subsequent decalcification in several days. This method of DNA extraction from the teeth, since it involves various steps and it is a very time-consuming method, it is not generally preferred over this method. Now, the new preparation, that is the new technique for DNA extraction from teeth, allows higher quality of quantity of quality DNA, which is critical in the forensic and legal fields. The project of developing this new technique is due to the observation that when we open the teeth without mixing the different tissues like the enamel, the dentine, and the pulp tissue is easier to isolate and it is better preserved. Ma'am, next slide. In this study, the authors had taken 16 teeth from a single skull and divided it into two groups. A group A went under the classical technique and group B into the new technique. Now, the classical technique, The following steps are, the teeth are received, the preparation with standard procedure. Briefly, each tooth is taken and pulverized using a Teflon ceramic pestle and a ceramic mortar. During the decalcification process, the resulting powder was dissolved in EDTA solution, and after the mixture was kept under DNA shaker for 4 days at room temperature in order to obtain the DNA from the mineral matrix. And after the fourth day, the mixture is filtered and lysed, and finally the DNA is obtained. Ma'am, next slide, please. Now, in the new procedure, each tooth, basically it was observed under the Nikon stereo microscope to determine the least damaged part of the tooth. The first image, it is a representative image of the teeth examination with the stereo microscope before the cleanup setup or any procedure is to be carried out. Now, in the apicocoronal axis, a 1 mm deep and 1 mm wide furrow was cut with the help of a carborundum disc using a sterile handpiece and a surgical micromotor. Figure 2, it is a representative image of the teeth that is undergoing the new procedure extraction, and they are showing the dentine in the image. Afterwards, the teeth are opened with a bi-beveled chisel and a med mallet with nylon ends, and the pulp cavity is exposed along with the part of the root canal. The third image is the representative image of opening and recovery of DNA in the pulp cavity and the root canal. And fourth is the representative image after the pulp has been removed and the reticular channels are visible. Now the harvested pulp material is, the harvested pulp material is rehydrated and lysed with a solution of buffer and proteinase K solution. The mixture is incubated at 56 degrees Celsius for 4 hours in sample tubes every hour. After the incubation, the supernatant is transferred into a filter column and centrifuged at 14,000 RPM to obtain a purified solution for DNA extraction. Now the new technique, it is based on direct tooth opening to collect dental paste from the endodontic system space without any chemical manipulation, and it displayed extremely advantageous results in terms of cost, time, quality, and the quantity of DNA extracted, which is extremely important in the forensic and the anthropological activity. Furthermore, the method can help the reduce the contamination by exogenous DNA, which gives uncertain results in the subsequent amplification techniques using the PCR. This new method could be useful to improve DNA extraction in special cases, such as ancient or badly preserved human remains, which in many situations is a priority in forensics. To conclude, I would like to say that the findings above provide an alternative protocol to obtain a higher amount of good quality DNA in a fast time procedure, which is helpful for forensic and anthropological studies. These are my references. Thank you.